to integralcalc.com. We're going to be doing another trapezoidal rule problem today. This one, the function that we're given, is the integral from 0 to 1 of 1 over e to the x plus 1 dx, where n equals 10. And we're asked to use the trapezoidal rule to approximate this function. So I wrote down the formula for the trapezoidal rule in the last video, but I think it's just so ridiculous that I find it unnecessary to actually write it down. I think it causes more confusion than anything. So I'm not going to actually write down the whole formula. I'm just going to go through how to solve the problem. The first thing that we need to do is find delta x, which is really simple to do. The way that we find delta x is by subtracting, we do the top number on the range here, 1, and we subtract the bottom number on the range, 0, and we divide by n. So we get 1 minus 0 is 1 over 10, which is the same thing as 0.1. So that's the first thing we do. We find delta x, we do the top number minus the bottom number divided by n. And basically what that tells us, n is the number of trapezoids that they want us to use to approximate the area under this graph or under this curve. So we're going to break it up into 10 trapezoids. And in order to do that, right, we need to divide the area from 0 to 1 into 10 sections, which means that when we find delta x, the first trapezoid is going to go from 0 to 0.1. The second trapezoid is going to go from 0.1 to 0.2. The third one from 0.2 to 0.3, all the way up until the last one, which goes from 0.9 to 1, if that makes sense. So once we find delta x, which is really simple to do, the next thing we want to go ahead and do is write down the areas where the trapezoids begin and end. So we write down x0. x0 is always the bottom number here, or the left-hand side of the range. So x0 is 0. x1, we just start adding delta x each time. So 0 plus 0.1 is 0.1, and we just keep adding delta x until we get to the second number or the top number in the range. So we're going to add 0.1 each time. So x3 is 0.3, x4 equals 0.4, x5 equals 0.5, x6 equals 0.6, x7 equals 0.7, x8 equals 0.8, x9 equals 0.9, and x10 equals 1. And now that I have reached the second number in the range, the right-hand limit of the range, or just the top number here on this integral, I can stop. I've got all of my values of x. So first step, find delta x. Second step, write out all these things. First number should be the bottom number here. Last number should be the top number here, and everything else in between, you just add delta x each time until you get here. So we've done that. Third step is to apply the trapezoidal rule. And basically what that looks like, we'll go ahead and write that down. You just plug in each one of these to our function here. So it's going to be super long, but we'll go ahead and write it down. So first number we're plugging in is 0 into this function here. So we just do 1 over e to the 0 plus 1. See how we plugged in 0 here for x? Now we're going to plug in 0.1. So plus 1 over e to the 0.1 plus 1. And we can just go ahead and keep doing this until we get all the way to the bottom. So this is going to be tedious. 0.2 plus 1 plus 1 over e to the 0.3 plus 1 plus 1 over e to the 0.4 plus 1, And this is where I'm going to stop talking because you're probably getting annoyed at my voice, and I think you get the point. And finally, you can see we've arrived at 0.9. We're going to do 1 over e to the 1 plus 1 is the last term. Since we've hit the last term, we're done. We can stop. We close out the bracket. So you plug in all these values to this function here, and you just add them all together. Now, once you've done that, I've left myself a little bit of space. The trapezoidal rule says that you multiply every term in here except the first one and the last one by 2. So I go ahead and put 2, 2, because we're going to multiply each one of these by 2, but not the first one and not the last one. So you can write everything out and then go back in and add 2 to all of that. So that's most of the formula, except the last thing we have to do. On the outside of this, we multiply by delta x, which we got was 0.1, over 2. The 2 always stays the same. It's just delta x over 2. You multiply that on the outside, and that is the entire formula. So first step, find delta x. Second step, write out all of these x terms here. Third step, plug them all into your function and just add them all together, multiply each term inside the brackets except the first one and the last one by 2, and then smack a delta x over 2 on the outside. And now all we need to do is simplify, and then use a calculator to solve. So I'm going to try to simplify this as quickly as possible. We have e to the 0 is 1. Anything raised to the 0 power is 1. So 1 plus 1 is 2. So the first term here is a 1/2. Then we've got, I'm just going to write this out, 2 over e to the 0.1 plus 1 plus 2 over e to the 0.2 plus 1 plus 2 over e to the 0.3 plus 1, and this is where I'm going to stop talking. Handwriting's really getting awful. And then remember, we don't multiply the first term or the last term by 2. So this is just e to the 1 is e. So this is just plus 1 over e plus 1. And then the whole thing, 0.1 divided by 2 is 0.05. So I hope you guys can see all of that. But that is pretty much as simplified as we're going to get. And now you would pick up your calculator and you would, let me see if I can write this out for you so we make sure that it's right. You would plug this whole thing into your calculator. So the beginning is going to look like this. Let me see. And then we'll have okay, so in your calculator, this is going to look like, if you have like a TI-89 or later, then you'll get to see more detail. But if you've got an older calculator, which I do, my problem in my calculator is starting to look like this. 2 divided by e to the 0.1 plus 1, make sure, oh, and, yeah, I've got this. So, I've got, you know, 1 half plus 2 over, and then the whole denominator here, and then I'll have plus 2 over e to the 0.2 plus 1, and then plus, and then I'll keep going. And because I realized that I was going to run into this problem and it was going to be extremely tedious, I went ahead and did the calculation ahead of time so that you didn't have to waste your time. The final answer that you should get when you do this whole calculation, and then of course go ahead and hit enter, and then multiply the whole thing by 0.05. When you finish the whole thing, the answer you should get is 0.37993, approximately, with some more decimal places, but that's rounded. So that'll be your final answer. I know it's a lot of work on the calculator, but you just you can't really make this simpler without busting out the old calculator. So go ahead and plug that all in. Be really careful about your parentheses so you make sure that you don't miss anything, or that the calculator doesn't misinterpret what you're trying to plug in, and see if you get 0.37993. Thanks, guys. I'll see you next time.